was a young child, my dad was in graduate school at UNC Chapel Hill. My bedtime stories would include pictures out of college textbooks of dinosaurs and other prehistoric animals. And when I found out that there were extinct animals, I was completely captivated. I think it's a basic human aspect of curiosity, of wanting to know how the world and life on this world have gotten to be the way that they are today. And paleontology is, I think, a great way to get at that.
That's a nice fossil, a jaw with a couple of teeth in it.
I've always had the idea that paleontology is a discipline that's driven by discovery. And the only way that you can make discoveries is by going to parts of the world that have largely been ignored by scientists and finding new discoveries out there. So that's one of the reasons that I spend so much time in places like Libya, Turkey, China, Myanmar, Kazakhstan, Cambodia, Egypt, Tunisia, Kenya, being out in the middle of nowhere and making a discovery right there and knowing that I'm seeing something no one has ever seen before. There's nothing better than that. It's fabulous. A big question that I've always been intrigued with: how, when, where, and perhaps even why did anthropoids evolve? Anthropoids, of course, being monkeys, apes, and humans. So I got started with this back in the early 90s working in China, and we found this fossil Eosimius there. Eos is Greek for dawn, and simius is Latin for monkey, so it literally means dawn monkey. It was living in Asia and not in Africa, where everybody thought the earliest anthropoids should be at that time. It was living at the wrong time. It was about 45 million years old instead of maybe 30 million years old. In fact, it's the most primitive and oldest fossil anthropoid that we have seen so far in the fossil record. And it had the wrong anatomy. It was small. If we had a whole one alive, it could easily fit in the palm of my hand. And most people thought that in order to become an anthropoid, you've got to get big. So Eosimius was a completely counterintuitive fossil. It's the kind of fossil that every paleontologist dreams of finding, and a fossil that has the impact in changing the way people think about evolution. It's taken 10, 15 years to get the rest of the scientific community to agree, but now that's happened too. I couldn't be prouder, I think, of any child than I am of Eosimius. It's an amazing specimen.
The troodons are obviously.
The foundation professor position here at KU is, I think, in many ways unique. The goals as being a liaison between different academic units within the university is something that I'm really attracted to. These little Gondwanan microplates that were previously associated with Africa were drifting northward, and they eventually collided with Turkey. Having colleagues both in paleontology and in allied disciplines, evolutionary biology and geology, who are leaders in their own right. So KU is blessed to have one of the best ecology and evolutionary biology programs in the country. As a research scientist, I'm thrilled to be in an environment like KU where scholarship, mentoring, and basic research are the bread and butter of what the institution is all about, and always will be. I'm so thankful to be here in Lawrence and at the University of Kansas. It's a great opportunity for me.